So shares in Israel's biggest drug company hit a six-month high as analysts welcome the company's new CEO. Teva Pharmaceutical climbed 3% in Israel on news that Jeremy Levin will take over the top job in May. But if we just look at where they are overall, you can see it's still down by more than 10% over the last 12 months, just giving you an idea, putting the share price into some perspective. Well, Stephen Tepper is a senior analyst for Pharma and Biomed at Harrell Finance, joins us now from the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange. And so if we just start with the new boss at Teva, what are your thoughts on him? Do you share the investor optimism that we're seeing, a 3% rise in the share price the last couple of days?
We at Harrell Finance really like this move. Dr. Jeremy Levin is a physician, he's a scientist, and he's a business leader. He has enormous experience in the pharmaceutical industry, in Bristol-Myers Squibb, in Novartis, and he's the right person at the right time to move Teva forward and really turn it into a global and fully integrated pharmaceutical company.
Stephen, you're very positive about him, and I know that you've talked about the new CEO being able to communicate Teva's value to Wall Street, but if we just look at where we've been in the U.S., the stock has fallen over the last 12 months, hasn't it? I mean, it was down more than, if we just look at that, it was down more than 20% in 2011 before the rally of the last couple of days. So I'm just wondering how difficult it's going to be for Jeremy Levin to convince U.S. investors of a company's value.
Well, the company is actually in a transition. It's a leader in the generic industry, and it has that great addition of Copaxone. But Copaxone is actually losing its patent soon, and the company has to move out of its dependence on Copaxone. And the current CEO, Shlomo Yonai, did a great job in diversifying the company. He diversified geographically into in Europe and in Japan and South America, and he's a diversified branded business with in women's health and the acquisition of Cephalon, and the joint venture with Procter & Gamble in OTC branded products. So Dr. Jeremy Levin is going to bring his innovative experience and continue developing, especially the branded side of Teva, to fully turn it into a global pharmaceutical company. And the stock, Dr. Jeremy Levin said in his conference call, that he's going to make much more transparency. And I think he's the person to really communicate the real value of Teva to Wall Street.
No, you're very, very bullish on this particular company. But I just want to move on and ask you about other Israeli biomed and pharma companies, Stephen. Prophylactics lost almost 50% last year after a delay in approving one of its drugs. Now, you're forecasting a rebound in the stock, right? Why is that?
Yeah, Protalix is its lead product, Opliso, for Gaucher's disease. We believe it will be approved in May. In 2011, we had a disappointment. There was two delays in the approval of the drug by the FDA. The FDA requested additional information, and Protalix gave that information. There was some technical delays. And after 14 months of delay, the stock fell 50%. But looking at the situation now, we believe they will be approved in May. And once it gets approved, and once we get towards that approval, this approval will bring validation to its platform and enable the company to go out and push additional products that they're developing into clinical development.
Stephen Tepper, senior analyst for Pharma and Biomed at Harrell Finance, thank you so much. Really good to talk to you from Tel Aviv. Back in 2 minutes. Stay with the Pulse.